You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give a glimpse of our country's diversity. Festivals in India revolve around birth anniversaries, traditions and religious beliefs. One such festival is that of Guru Purv, which is celebrated every year to mark the birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Sahib, the first Sikh Guru and the founder of Sikhism. Recently, the festival of Guru Purv was celebrated in Amritsar city of Punjab with great pomp and fervor.
A pool of Sikh devotees gathered at Golden Temple, the holiest Sikh shrine in northern Amritsar city, to mark the birth anniversary of Guru Nanak Dev. Said to be the founder of Sikhism and also the first of the 10 Sikh Gurus, his birthday is celebrated in the form of Guru Nanak Jayanti or Guru Purv. One of the most sacred festivals of the Sikh community in the country, the festival falls during the Hindu month of Kartik, which coincides with the Gregorian month of October-November. On the occasion, Sikh devotees took holy dips, lit diyas and offered prayers early in the day to mark the anniversary.
ਬਹੁਤ ਅੱਛਾ ਲੱਗ ਰਿਹਾ ਅੱਜ ਗੁਰੂ ਜੀ ਦਾ ਜਨਮ ਦਿਨ ਦਿਹਾੜਾ ਪੂਰੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਵਿੱਚ ਮਨਾਇਆ ਜਾ ਰਿਹਾ ਸਭ ਨੂੰ ਬਾਬਾ ਜੀ ਤੰਦਰੁਸਤੀਆਂ ਦੇ ਦੇਹ ਰੁਕਤਾ ਦਾਨ ਬਖਸ਼ ਜੋ ਬਿਮਾਰੀ ਇਸ ਨੂੰ ਜਲਦ ਤੋਂ ਜਲਦ ਖਤਮ ਕਰਨ ਦੀ ਕਿਰਪਾਲਤਾ ਕਰਨ ਸਭ ਤੇ ਮਿਹਰ ਭਰਿਆ ਹੱਥ ਰੱਖ
The Golden Temple was also illuminated with different LED lights on the auspicious occasion and the devotees witnessed a colorful fireworks show in the evening. Celebrated with great fervor and enthusiasm, the festival spreads Guru Nanak's universal messages of oneness.
ਅਸੀਂ ਹਰ ਸਾਲ ਆਨੇ ਆ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਆ ਜਾਂ ਗੁਰੂ ਰਾਮਦਾਸ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਗੁਰਪੁਰਬ ਆਈਏ ਜਾਂ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਸਾਹਿਬ ਜੀ ਦੇ ਗੁਰਪੁਰਬ ਆਈਏ ਕਿ ਬਹੁਤ 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 ਪਿਆਰਾ ਨਜ਼ਾਰਾ ਹੈ ਅੱਖਾਂ 'ਚ ਅਥਰੂ ਨਹੀਂ ਖਤਮ ਹੁੰਦੇ
Guru Nanak Dev, the first Sikh Guru, was born in Nankana Sahib on the full moon day in 1469 in the Kartik month of the Hindu calendar. His birthday is celebrated as Guru Nanak Jayanti.
ਅਰਦਾਸ ਇਹ ਹੋਈ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਕਾਇਨਾਤ ਦਾ ਸਮੁੱਚੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਦਾ ਮਾਨਵਤਾ ਦੇ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਦਾ ਸਰਬੱਤ ਦਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਵਾ ਉਹ ਭਲਾ ਮੰਗਿਆ ਗਿਆ ਵਾ ਤੇ ਜਗਤ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਪ੍ਰਮਾਤਮਾ ਜਿਹੜਾ ਸਾਰਿਆਂ ਲਈ ਸੁੱਖ ਤੇ ਖੁਸ਼ੀਆਂ ਲੈ ਕੇ ਆਵੇ
Sikhism was founded in the 15th century in Punjab, an area straddling the border between Pakistan and India, by Guru Nanak Dev and has had 10 successive gurus.
Sufism has entrenched itself at the center of cultural and spiritual life in India. The Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir serves as the richest reservoir of this tradition, and this can be well witnessed during the Urs of Sufi saints in the region, when people cutting across religious lines gather under one roof. So, giving a glimpse of this unique devotional culture, today we take you to the Urs commemoration of Mir Syed Hussain Sinmani that was recently commemorated in Kulgam district of Jammu and Kashmir. Take a look. The shrine of Sufi saint Syed Hussain Sinmani, located in the Kulgam district, is an abode of peace and tranquility. People cutting across all religious lines gathered at the shrine to attend the 683rd Urs of the Holy Saint. They offered special prayers at the shrine and wished for peace and prosperity to prevail across the nation.
वो हमेशा भाईचारा और प्यार और मोहब्बत की यहाँ पर तालीम दिया करते थे। यहाँ पर उनका एक तरबियत गाह था जहाँ पर इस वक्त यहाँ पर उनके आस्थाना पर इस वक्त उर्स मुबारक मनाया जा रहा है। और यहाँ पर हम रात भर लोगों को यही पैगाम देते रहे कि जो सूफियानी इज़ाम औलियाई कश्मीर की जो तालीम है और उनकी तालीम यही थी भाईचारा प्यार और मोहब्बत अखुवत, उन पर बहुत ज़्यादा वो मतलब फोकस किया करते थे, दरस दिया करते थे। तो हमें भी वही प्यार मोहब्बत और अखुवत और भाई के चारा के साथ और अमन के साथ रहना चाहें।
It's been said that the saint came from the Semnan area of Iran and settled in Kulgam. As part of the celebrations, holy verses of the Quran were recited and resounded at the shrine. Every year, the Urs of the Sufi saint is celebrated according to the lunar or Islamic calendar and is attended by all male and female, young and old devotees, not just from the district but from the entire territory of Jammu and Kashmir.
इनका हमें इतना एहतराम है, इतना आदर है सारे डिस्ट्रिक्ट को कि यहाँ सारे लोग आते हैं, बड़े दिनों के बगैर भी यहाँ हाजिरी लोगों की चलते रहती है, आते रहते हैं। तो इंशाल्लाह ये हमारे लिए मुबारक दिन है और इनका पैगाम रहा यही कि इंसानियत दोस्ती अमन जब ये आए हैं तो उन्होंने उस वक्त क्योंकि यहाँ और जबान थी, उनकी और जबान थी, पर्शियन जबान थी, अरबिक जबान थी, तो उन्होंने फौरी तौर पर यहाँ आकर उनको कुरान नहीं पढ़ाया सिखाया बल्कि अपने अखलाक से अपने अमन की कोशिश से उन्होंने लोगों को अपनी तरफ से मायल किया।
Forming an integral part of the public ethos for the last several centuries, even today, the Sufi traditions play an important role in the lives of the people and connote them with an understanding of the world in all its spiritual dimensions. Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Bollywood actors Shahid Kapoor and Mrunal Thakur recently promoted their upcoming sports drama film Jersey in India's showbiz capital Mumbai. It is one of the earliest theatre releases of Bollywood after the COVID-19 pandemic restrictions started to ease in the country.
Having shops shut for 2 years and not knowing what's going to happen is a very scary feeling. And this film is all about the victory of the human spirit. So I think it has great context for the times today. I think it's more relevant today than even when it was when we started shooting it.
Jersey is a remake of a Telugu blockbuster of the same title and follows the story of late bloomers who aspire to do big but are pulled back by several life complications and previous failures. Directed by National Award-winning filmmaker Gautam Tinna Noori, the film is expected to hit the theatres on December 31. Hindu devotees across northern India recently took holy dips in religiously revered rivers on morning to mark the auspicious occasion of Kartik Purnima, the full moon day of 7th month of Hindu calendar. Devotees in Prayagraj, Varanasi and Kanpur cities offered prayers and performed rituals as they bathed in rivers on the occasion.
हरि हर मिलन का ये सबसे महत्वपूर्ण महीना माना गया है। आज के दिन ही शंकर भगवान और नारायण का मिलन होता है, इसलिए कार्तिक की इस तिथि का बहुत विशेष ही योगदान है और सारे लोग महान नदियों में और सरोवरों में स्नान करते हैं और दान पुण्य करते हैं। इस दिन का किया गया दान हजारों गुना हर तिथि से उत्तम और हजारों गुना माना गया है।
अकॉर्डिंग टू रिलीजियस बिलीव्स, बेदिंग इन रिवर गंगा और अदर्स ऑन कार्तिक पूर्णिमा washes away all sins and leads to salvation. A visual artist Manveer Singh created a sculpture from plastic waste at an Indian beach to raise awareness about its impact on Olive Ridley sea turtles. The 15 feet plastic sculpture shaped like a turtle seems like to be going towards the sea. With his depiction, he wants to depict that instead of turtles, plastic is entering the seas.
इनका एक बहुत बड़ा रोल है ये पूरा अर्थ का लाइफ सर्कल को मेंटेन करके रखने का। तो मैं यहाँ पर मोर देन 250 जो टर्टल है मैंने वो डिस्प्ले किया है और वो सभी मिलकर एक बड़ा एक टर्टल का फॉर्म ले रहे हैं जो कि मोर देन 15 फीट है। तो इसके थ्रू मैं बस अपना यही दिखा रहा हूँ कि हम एक भ्रम है कि हम किस भ्रम में जी रहे हैं कि हम दूर से देख रहे हैं कि टर्टल है लेकिन वो सिर्फ एक प्लास्टिक ही है।
ओडिशा होस्ट द लार्जेस्ट नेस्टिंग ग्राउंड्स फॉर दीज एंडेंजर्ड स्पीसीज इन द वर्ल्ड। Millions of olive ridley turtles hatch at Odisha beaches every season. However, confusing plastic waste for jellyfish or food, many turtles end up eating them, resulting in a painful death.
And now we will take you to Midnapur city of West Bengal, where the shrine of Sufi saint Hazrat Balak Shahid has been uniting different religious communities for years.
Away from the hustle and bustle of the city lies the revered shrine of Hazrat Balak Shahid at the Sheikhpura area of West Bengal's Midnapur city. Thronged by people of all faiths, the shrine plays a distinctive role in narrowing down the boundaries of religion and promoting peace and harmony.
Sampradayer manush ache amra eshechi to amader porokal jate bhalo hoy বা আমরা সম্প্রীতি যাতে বজায় রাখতে পারি, ভাতৃত্ববোধ যাতে এনাদের যে শিক্ষা সেগুলো অর্জন করতে পারি, সেই উদ্দেশ্য নিয়ে আমরা ফুরফুরা শরীফের ওসিলা নিয়ে ডানকুনি থেকে এসেছি। বিভিন্ন মানুষ এখানে সব সম্প্রদায়ের মানুষ এসে এই জল গ্রহণ করে নেয়, তারা পান করে বা তাদের উপকারের কথাও এখানে ঘোষণা করে যে আমরা এই উপকার পেয়েছি। সেই উদ্দেশ্য নিয়ে জলের মহত্ব অনেক বেশি।
The main attraction at this shrine is the Fakir Kua, a well whose water never dries up and is consumed by devotees, irrespective of caste and communities. It is believed that when the saint came to Midnapur in 1765, he used this water to treat various stomach diseases. Even today, devotees draw water from this well with the belief that the water has healing properties.
इनका जो कुआं का पानी अगर पीने से हर बला जो है, हर मुसीबत है अच्छा हो जाता है, बीमारी अच्छा हो जाता है। इसी मकसद से हम लोग आए हैं, इधर पानी पिए, जो बीमारी है वो शिफा हो जाएगा, इसी उम्मीद से आए हैं।
The shrine has been for years giving out loud the message of communal harmony as people of various faiths visit it to pay their obeisance to the saint.
Kashmir is truly a year-round travel destination. All its seasons, be it summer or winter, have the allure that beckons travelers from all over India and abroad. During this time, the autumn season is on and tourists in large numbers are flocking the valley to enjoy its new look with dazzling leaves of chinar trees covering the whole landscape.
Popularly known as Harud in Kashmir, autumn season in the valley offers a mesmerizing beauty to the tourist in the form of yellow, crimson and gold hues. It is regarded as the most beautiful among all the seasons as the maple leaves of majestic chinar trees turn from green to gold, offering a complete mystical look. During this time, tourists mostly prefer to visit Mughal gardens such as Nishat Shalimar, where they get to see this majestic scene.
पर्टिकुलरली जो मुगल गार्डन्स हैं, मुगल गार्डन्स में हमारी कंसंट्रेशन चिनार्स की बहुत ज़्यादा है, उस वजह से ये ऑटम की मतलब एक मुनफरिद अट्रैक्शन बन जाता है मुगल गार्डन्स। निशात, शालीमार, हमारे अगर निशात की बात करें उसमें कोई 225 चिनार्स हमारे पास हैं और वो एक प्रॉपर पैटर्न में लगे हुए हैं। तो एक जिसको बोलते हैं ऑटम का जो ह्यू होता है, वो जो एक मॉस इफेक्ट होता है, वो अट्रैक्ट करता है नेशनल टूरिस्ट्स को, लोकल टूरिस्ट्स को, इंटरनेशनल टूरिस्ट्स को। इवन फ़ोटोशूट्स होते हैं, वेडिंग फ़ोटोशूट्स यहाँ पे होते हैं। तो ऑटम भी एक ऐसा सीज़न है जिसकी बहुत ज़्यादा अट्रैक्शन है और टूरिस्ट को अट्रैक्ट करने में ऑटम का बहुत ज़्यादा रोल है और पोटेंशियल भी है जो हम फर्दर एक्सप्लोर कर सकते हैं।
Chinar, that dots the autumn landscape of Kashmir, was also described as Atish Chinar, meaning the Chinar on fire, by the famous Urdu poet Allama Iqbal.
It also shares a number of amazing facts with Kashmir Valley. Some say that Chinars were brought to Kashmir from Iran. Others say they have come from Greece. The world's oldest and biggest Chinar tree, which is 627 years old, is found at a garden of Muslim shrine in central Kashmir. According to renowned environmentalist Muhammad Sultan Wadu, the tree was planted by a Sufi saint, Sayyid Abul Qasim Shah Hamdani, in a garden at Chhatargam in 1374 AD. Today, the shedding of these Chinar trees, locally known as Buin, attracts a number of tourists who come to see its glorious beauty in autumn. They even love to explore the local lifestyle and can be seen capturing their memorable moments on phones or cameras.
बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है हमने ऐसा कहीं नहीं देखा मैं तो स्विट्जरलैंड भी जाकर आई लेकिन ऐसा मेरे को कहीं नहीं मिला बहुत अच्छा नेचुरल ब्यूटी है यहाँ सब रियल में बहुत अच्छा है
या इट इज़ ब्यूटीफुल रियली ब्यूटीफुल क्योंकि हाँ अभी जो फोटोग्राफी हो रही है और जो हम एनवायरमेंट देख रहे हैं रियली वी आर एंजॉइंग इट
बिसाइड्स गेटिंग एनगल्फ्ड इन द ब्यूटी ऑफ चिनार वन कैन ऑल्सो टेक अ शिकारा राइड ऑन डल लेक to enjoy the fabulous autumn weather of Kashmir. Altogether, it is the best season to be outdoors and enjoy the fragrance in the air with very comfortable temperatures. Moreover, the people of Kashmir also start collecting leaves of chinar during autumn and burn them in a pile to make coal for their kangri, a traditional fire pot which helped them in braving the harsh winters. Thus, apart from serving as a major draw for the tourists, the chinar leaves also help the locals to fight the chilling cold conditions.
At last, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our section of World in Focus. To protect citizens from rainwater disaster, there is a huge water underground storage facility in Tokyo. Wada Yayoi Trunk Sewer is one of the largest rainwater storage lines in Japan. It is a huge storage facility with an inner diameter of 8.5 meters, a length of 2.2 kilometers, a storage capacity of 150,000 tons and a storage capacity of 25 meters. Due to the Wada Yayoi Trunk Sewer, water is poured into the reservoir to prevent any kind of disaster.
令和元年の東日本台風の際にはですね、和田弥生艦船とその集水艦合わせて貯留量約15万トン、すべてですね、まあ満杯になるというような形になりまして、地域の浸水被害の貢献に大きく貢献しているものというふうに考えております。
Tokyo sewage system is built in a way to prevent all kinds of rainwater disasters, which guarantee safety of all citizens. A rare carpet from the Imperial Palace in Beijing's Forbidden City, hidden from the public eye in the last 34 years, will be auctioned in Christie's, Paris. Woven in the Ming Dynasty in the 16th century, the square carpet is adorned with 2 5-clawed dragons and a pearl motif at its center, and would have been placed on a dais under the emperor's throne.
So this is an incredible, magnificent imperial 16th century Ming dragon throne carpet. And that basically means that this was woven at the in the 16th century for the emperors in the Forbidden City. There was an imperial workshop that created these carpets solely for the interiors of the halls within the Forbidden City. This particular carpet, due to its shape and its decoration, was woven specifically for the emperor's throne. And this was a square format raised above the floor level on which the emperor's throne would have been placed.
It is estimated at 3.5 to 4.5 million euros, that is 3.95 to 5.06 million US dollars, and is one of the 7 complete imperial dragon throne carpets in private collection. The 9 others remain in the Beijing Palace Museum. Souvenir store Hida Komachi sells special soft cream. The shop's original product is jam and sauce, which is made from local ingredients. Another popular sweet is soft cream, which is made from cow milk and peach.
地元の特徴あるソフトクリームを作りたいと思いまして、それで飛騨牛乳を使った、ソフトクリームを作りたいと思って作りました。飛騨の高原で採れた牛乳をなるべくそのまま成分を微調整で、低温殺菌したものをそのまま素材の味を生かした牛乳になっています。独自で自分で考えまして、その後日清さんと相談しながら開発しました。飛騨牛乳の味を生かすために、
Tourists enjoy the rich and refreshing taste of this ice cream. Soft cream developed by Hida Komachi and Nissei attract a lot of tourist attention and represent the desserts of the area. The Riyadh Car Show opened its doors on November 18 and offers visitors an exhibition of 600 cars, including collectibles and exotic vehicles, with a total value of 2 billion SARS, around 0.5 billion US dollars. The car show's most expensive car, the Ferrari 250 GTO, cost 400 million SAR, around 106.6 million US dollars. An auction will be organized as part of the event where visitors will be able to purchase the car of their dreams.
Someone has really gone through a lot of trouble to curate like really exceptionally rare and special cars that I don't think you can find all in one place anywhere in the world. There's an old Skyline, there's some beautiful Mustangs, really, really nice Ferrari exhibit, and a host of beautiful McLarens. So it's really cool to be out here as part of Riyadh season at the car show.
The Riyadh Car Show is part of the Riyadh season, a 5-month festival launched in October 2021. That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@nin.com. I'm your host, Karim Zimik, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.